Willa Hepie. Mr. Stelios Hachi Yanu. Ah, Mr. EasyJet, the man with the orange planes. All right. The tickets are on you. Thank you very much. Kostte maar 95 gulden per stuk. I'm on my way. Dat zijn nog eens reiskostenvergoedingen. Vandaag ga ik een dag aan het werk voor Stelios Hajianu, eigenaar van de luchtvaartmaatschappij EasyJet. Je weet wel, met die hele goedkope vluchten waar KLM en British Airways helemaal gek van worden. En hij betaalt mijn ticket naar Londen. Waar Stelios Hajianu onder andere ook op bezuinigt, dat is dat hij veel meer stoelen in die kisten zet. Waardoor je dus echt heel erg krap zit. Dus ik snak naar een voertuig met iets meer beenruimte, zoals een Londense taxi. Meneer Stelios heeft het zo druk met EasyJet. Hij heeft geen tijd voor een vrouw, hij heeft geen tijd voor een kind, hij heeft zelfs geen tijd voor een huis. Dus hij woont in dit hotel. Good morning, Mr. Hachi.
Good morning, Milan. Don't worry about the surname. Call me Stelios, okay?
I've been practicing your name. How does it pronounced?
Hajianu, but really you have to call me Stelios like everybody else.
Mr. Okay? Stelios.
Well, let's start with that and see.
Mr. Stelios, okay.
Go there and find
taxi.
A taxi.
Oh, here's a taxi. Mr. Stelios, here's a taxi.
No, we can't take a debonair taxi.
Can we take this, please? Are you free? I missed my cup of coffee in the plane this morning.
Ah, yeah, well, it's a very short flight.
I know it's a short flight, but still, I missed my cup of coffee.
Well, have one at the airport.
Oh, but there were nice stewardesses.
Oh, thank
very
you.
Nice.
Thank you.
Yeah.
The idea is that they have to be
and there
nice
were
to people.
Two pilots, which
yeah.
is good.
Yeah, of course. Yes. You need to.
Yeah. Well, I thought because it's so cheap, maybe there's only one pilot.
No.
You like power?
Do I like power? If you follow my business career, you know, I was born out of a rich Greek shipping family.
Very rich.
So in essence, we had power in that industry, in the shipping industry. And then what do I do? I leave that industry and I go to the airline industry where we're tiny. You know, and we start from scratch with two aeroplanes. What I do as soon as I get to a position of relative comfort or strength, I go to the next industry.
So with EasyJet, you're relatively comfortable.
Well,
I believe
EasyJet is now okay.
It's going to fly on its own.
It's going well. I mean, we can't even answer.
You're not
going
to fight nice wars with KLM and British Airways.
We always fight nice wars.
Okay, Mr. Stelios.
Thank you. I'll take care of the taxi. How much?
You're a gentleman.
It's not from the Financial Times. Let's get the Telegraph. I hope you don't mind me reading this paper, but I always like a tabloid newspaper as well.
Why do you read that? Look.
Because I want to find out what
your favorite
think.
Woman.
Ah, Monica.
Monica.
Ever since mobile phones were invented, I think my mother is calling me twice a day, no matter where I am. You know, sometimes it's difficult because I have to be rude to her and say I'm in a meeting.
I'm in a meeting, Mom. Don't you miss Greece, Mr. Stelios? It's so cold here.
Yes, I do miss Greece, and I miss the weather particularly, but I do go back quite often because we have a flight from London to Athens. I jump on the plane every second week almost.
Let me carry your
bags
for you. You missed the train. Thank you.
When I was younger, the days of Johan Cruyff.
You know, Johan Cruyff?
Yeah.
So your planes are orange, and you know the color of our national team is also orange.
Absolutely.
Very, so why don't you fly our national team, our national soccer team?
Well, you should suggest it to them and see next time whether...
Shall I call Frank Rijkaard, the Bonds coach?
Will you arrange that deal?
I will call him today.
Which, I think it's Transavia that usually flies.
No, it's Martinair.
Martinair that flies the team around?
Yes.
After you.
Thank you. Welcome to the world of EasyJet.
Nearly, we're not quite there yet.
Oh, Mr. Stelios, you're not really a man of the limousine, eh? You like public transportation. Well,
sometimes I use limousines. I
mean, you do?
It's not a point of principle for me, but I find it useful to actually use the same means of transport that, you know, any ordinary person would. So, you know, not all the time, but quite often I do this trip on purpose by train and by bus to see what it's like for the ordinary customer.
For you, a plane is no more than a bus with wings, isn't
exactly,
it?
Exactly. Anyway.
You treat it like that, no?
Mm-hmm. I mean, on a 40-minute flight, what sort of services can you offer? Not a lot, anyway.
No. Thank you.
Right. This is the airport, but we're going to the office now. Okay.
All right. You really like orange, don't you, Mr. Stelios?
Yes, I do.
So why orange? Why orange?
Well, first of all, I was looking for a color that no other airline was using. Most airlines are either
using... You succeeded.
Yeah, well, exactly. Nobody wanted to use it maybe
ugly,
at the beginning.
Because it's ugly, Mr. Stelios.
Most airlines use blue, like KLM or British Airways. Some use red, a couple of green ones, yellow ones, whatever, but nobody was using orange, so I chose that color.
Okay.
I also believe it's very good for marketing purposes. It's stands out, so you can't miss an orange advertisement.
You can't miss an orange plane.
And I also think it has a good connotation, because if you think about it, it's the color of safety.
Color of most, safety?
Yeah, most safety equipment are actually orange. If you look at life buoys on ships and some life jackets and
you
everything.
You really think about everything. Yeah. Wow. It's true, life jackets are orange.
She looks great in orange. Hi.
She looks great in orange. Very subtle the way you put that phone number on the plane.
Absolutely.
Very subtle.
So, this is our headquarters.
This
Very
is your
humble.
Palace.
Yeah.
Humble headquarters. Don't ruin my
And
suit,
we go.
Mr.
Do you want a coffee?
Sir. Yes, please.
Let's go for a coffee.
I should get you coffee, no?
No, it's all right. I always help myself to the coffee machine.
You never had a secretary? No. Never had a personal
assistant?
Well,
I used to have a secretary. I used to have three secretaries at some stage.
Three?
I decided it's not worth it.
So what's happening here?
This is really the heart of the company. This is the call center. This is where we answer all the calls from all over Europe. We have Dutch people in here who answer the calls in Dutch. They are working 24 hours a day. People are very motivated because they earn a commission on every flight.
Aha.
So they make 80 pence, English pence or pound,
on every flight
for every
they book.
Seat they sell. So they're very motivated, they're sitting down, they're working, they're selling seats. They have to be nice to the customer, otherwise they don't sell.
Can you explain to me how it's possible that you can make flying so cheap?
It's quite simple, actually. It's three things.
Three things.
First of all, is cut out the travel agents. No middlemen, no travel agents.
No travel agents.
We do it through the call center or the internet.
Second
is no free lunch on board. So you don't get anything for free on the plane, as you know. You can buy things, but nothing is for free.
Okay.
And the third thing is Luton itself. It's cheaper than using Heathrow. So if you add the three things together, is cheaper to sell a seat than KLM.
And
everything has to go back to one seat.
There are no tickets.
Yeah, that's part of the no travel agent. So you simplify the process. You say, because I don't meet travel agents, I will not issue tickets. I will not go on the expensive computer reservation systems that the other airlines use. So all of these things go together with the no travel agents. Again, the no free lunch on board means you don't have to carry as many cabin crew members.
Mm-hmm.
The KLM would fly the same aeroplane with six cabin crew members on board.
Mm-hmm.
We fly with three, which is the safety standard. We have two pilots, don't worry about that.
Yes. You don't economize on the engines, pilots,
The aeroplanes are brand new and we don't economize on pilot training.
Very nice.
These things are very strictly controlled.
Okay.
Good morning. Morning.
Do you have walls in your office, Mr.?
No.
No walls.
Everybody's open plan.
Okay.
This is the desk I use.
This is your desk?
Yeah. Not a very big one, huh?
This is your desk?
Yeah.
This is all?
This is it.
Where's your privacy?
I have no privacy. Well, there are meeting rooms if you want to have a private meeting. But we all work open plan here.
Okay.
So, let's get a chair for you.
When you call your Monica Lewinsky, where do you do that?
This is my name, this is my inbox, so click on it.
I go in your inbox.
Yeah. Click on this and drag it to the bottom. KLM, Dutch Placekeeping. Although I don't live in Holland, I sort of try and find out what's happening in Holland through the press clippings.
How are your connections today with the KLM?
We are not fighting in court anymore, because what has happened is, although the first year was very difficult and we're losing a lot of money on the London to Amsterdam route, I think what has happened is that the market grew and more people started flying to London and back.
My word is so angry,
we're both full. So they are filling their aeroplanes, we are filling our aeroplanes, and we are happy with the profitability.
Okay.
So it's, everybody is happy suddenly. And I think they've said it's not worth fighting this guy. Obviously, he's not going to go away.
No.
The assumption when a small airline starts is that if they lose, you know, a lot of money in the first 6 months, they might go out of business. Of course, they never sort of put into the equation the fact that I have a rich father.
Hey, that's so what daddy saved your ass.
So they didn't.
I'm sorry. Mr. Stallions.
Mm-hmm. You have to translate this to me.
I'm going to translate
this
for
is a
you.
Good job for you to translate the Dutch press clippings for me.
Merger Martinair,
yeah,
by KLM, mm-hmm, still uncertain. European Commission tells KLM that they will not get permission to take over Martinair. They will not get permission.
Very rightly they shouldn't. I mean, I agree.
It's good news
of course,
for you.
I agree with Mr. Van Meert. I mean,
because
KLM is a powerful company. They have such a big percentage of the Dutch market. They should not be allowed to buy another company. No, I think that's very.
So you can buy Martinair. Shall we make an offer? They can't refuse. What shall we bid? Martinair, shall we make an offer? They can't refuse. What shall we bid?
Another day. We'll buy the Martinair another day. Okay.
Okay.
You know something else I do with my people and my companies? I think it's always good to create an external enemy. You know, you always fight someone outside. So we started fighting the KLM, then that's over. We now fight British Airways. It's very important to keep people in a company excited and driven by convincing them that they are at war, really. Business is a bit like fighting a war.
Brothers, yeah.
And they are more productive, I think they're more dedicated. You know, we have our meetings standing up sometimes. We call
standing up meetings.
We call them war meetings.
And then you go, you put on the colors and the feathers. And
Close. these are our interviews today.
Okay.
So let's see what people were saying for the job.
This is only to talk about the skills, not about the salary today. Salary is with someone else. Or do you?
Because it's a new company, probably we'll have to talk about salary. But the salary,
The
salary was advertised with the job.
Oh, how much?
They have an expectation. I think we said about £80,000.
What qualities do you look for? With the people you are going for the job?
I believe that people should have, obviously, the skills that you hire them for. Beyond that, we really believe that it's attitude we're hiring, it's
self-confidence,
ability to absorb change, I think is very important.
Okay.
Because we're a constantly changing organization,
yes,
we don't like people who are set in their ways,
like
exactly,
this.
With blinkers.
No. Okay.
We like people who are willing to change.
Hello.
Hi, Nick.
Hi,
sorry.
Welcome to Iceland. Pleased to meet you.
Hello.
This is my PA for the day.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Right, thank you for taking the time to come and see me here in Luton.
Pleasure.
Mr. Stelius.
So,
Courage?
Courage.
Flexibility. Fighter's mentality.
That's the requirement for the job. Do you think you possess that?
What do you do when you get mad?
When I get mad? I bang things, I shout.
Okay, physical aggression.
Physical aggression.